In this video, we start talking about the common types of chemical reaction, and we're going to focus on synthesis reactions and decomposition reactions. The first type of chemical reaction is a synthesis reaction, which is sometimes called a combination reaction. A synthesis reaction takes place when two or more reactants come together to form just one product. So a quick way to recognize a synthesis reaction is that there is no plus sign on the right-hand side of the reaction because there is only one product. In the examples below, we're going to predict the products for some synthesis reactions. Notice that in each case, I start with multiple reactants. So in the first example, I'm starting with magnesium and oxygen. They're going to come together to form just one compound. So the first thing I'm going to do is list the atoms that are present, which in this case are magnesium and oxygen. Anytime you create a compound when you're predicting products, you should be aware that you need to cross down your charges. So you want to check the periodic table. You'll find that the charge of magnesium is +2, the charge of oxygen is -2. Those don't need to be crossed down because they balance out. So we have correctly predicted that the product is magnesium oxide. The last thing that you should do is balance the equation. I have two oxygens on the left and only one on the right, so I'm going to put a 2 here. Then I need a 2 here to balance out the magnesiums. That is a correct chemical equation. It is a synthesis reaction because there is only one product, and we have correctly predicted that product. Let's look at the next example. In the next example, we have lithium and fluorine. They're going to come together to form lithium fluoride. And anytime we make a compound, we want to check the charges. Lithium has a charge of +1. Fluoride has a charge of -1. When you cross those down, you don't need any additional subscripts. However, we do need to balance. So I'm going to put a 2 here to balance out the fluorines, and then I need a 2 here to balance out the lithiums. My last example is a synthesis reaction involving aluminum and sulfur. So I'm going to go ahead and create a compound that has those two elements. I do need to check the charges for that compound. Aluminum has a charge of +3. Sulfur has a charge of -2. They don't match, so I need to cross down the charges to put a 3 here for the sulfur and a 2 for the aluminum. So Al2S3 gives me aluminum sulfide. Then I need to balance the reaction by putting a 2 here and a 3 here. These are all synthesis reactions. They all have two or more reactants combining to form one product, and when you predict what that one product is, you need to make sure that you cross down your charges. Decomposition reactions are like the opposite of synthesis reactions. You start with one reactant, and it breaks apart into two or more products. These are a little bit more difficult to predict because you can have multiple products. There are some trends that help us to predict the products that will be formed in a decomposition reaction. These are some guidelines. In these guidelines, anytime you see a capital M, that stands for some metal, and anytime you see a capital NM, that stands for a nonmetal. So the first thing that we can predict is the metal carbonates. If you have a metal carbonate, it is going to break apart into a metal oxide plus carbon dioxide. Now you still need to check your charges whenever you create these new structures. The metal oxide, you would want to find the charges on the periodic table and then cross them down. Carbon dioxide is not going to change. Its charges are already correct. Metal hydrogen carbonates, or bicarbonates, are going to break apart in a predictable fashion to form a metal oxide with water and carbon dioxide. So this metal is not going to change. You just need to check the charges when you form the metal oxide. Metal hydroxides are going to break apart to form a metal oxide plus water. Metal chlorates are going to break apart to form a metal chloride plus oxygen. And then anytime you have an acid typically starts with an H, that acid is going to decompose to form a nonmetal oxide plus water. Let's look at some examples. Here are some examples of decomposition reactions where we are going to be predicting our products, and we're going to be using these rules to help us predict our products. Notice I can recognize that they are all decomposition reactions because there is only one reactant. These things are going to break down into two or more products. The first example is potassium carbonate. So I'm going to go to this rule about the carbonates. Potassium is a metal, so I'm looking at a situation where a metal carbonate is going to break down into a metal oxide plus carbon dioxide. In this case, my metal is potassium, and the reaction is going to form potassium oxide plus carbon dioxide. So I can predict that it's going to be KO plus CO2. However, I need to check the charges on that potassium oxide that I just created. Potassium has a charge of plus 1. Oxygen has a charge of minus 2. Those charges are going to need to get crossed down, so I get K2O. The last thing that you would want to do is make sure that the reaction is balanced. One nice thing about the metal carbonates, the fashion in which they break down, your reaction should always be balanced, but it's a good idea to check. Our second example is potassium hydroxide. So I'm going to go to this rule about the hydroxides. A metal hydroxide is going to break apart into a metal oxide plus water. So this time my metal is potassium, so it's going to form potassium oxide plus water. And keep in mind, every time you form a compound, you want to check your charges. Potassium is plus 1, oxygen's minus 2. You want to cross those down to get K2O. This last example is for the decomposition of sodium chlorate. So I'm going to go to this rule about the chlorates. In this case, sodium is my metal. A metal chlorate is going to decompose to form a metal chloride plus oxygen. So when I go to predict my products, sodium is my metal, is going to be with chloride this time, and I need to check my charges on that. Sodium has a charge of plus 1, chloride has a charge of minus 1, so there would be ones for subscripts, plus oxygen. Oxygen is a diatomic, so it gets a 2. The last thing you would want to do is balance that equation. This equation needs to have a 3 here and a 2 here to balance the oxygens, and then another 2 here to balance the rest of the equation. So these rules that we have really help us to predict the products of decomposition reactions. Now that we've seen how synthesis and decomposition reactions work, stick around for the next video where we look at single replacement reactions and the activity series.